Good evening. Today we will study how to conduct a online lecture through Google Meet. So the first thing that you have to do is go to Google and just type Google Meet like this. When you type Google Meet, on your screen you will find the first link, that is meet.google.com. Just click on it. When you click on that, this window will come where you will find joining or start meeting button. Just click that button. So here another pop-up window will come. It mentions you that enter the meeting code or nickname to start your meeting. Enter nickname or leave blank. So you can put anything here. I am mentioning my name here and click on continue. Once it is done, you will find this screen on your window. There you will find a button called join now and another button is present. So right now I want to join a new session. So I will click on join now button. When you click on join now button, you will find a new pop-up window that comes on your screen. There you will get the information of your meeting link that you want to share with your students, so that by clicking on that link you can ask your student to join your live session. You can copy it and you can send it through WhatsApp or through email also. There is another thing called as add people. You can also add the people you want to add in your online lecture from this. Just by clicking add people, an invitation email will go to the respected people, right? So whenever you mention here any email, if I want to send an invitation to join this lecture for Swapna Patil, then I will put the name Swapna Patil, her email ID say, and then this is the button to invite her. Click send invite. The invitation is sent and your screen is ready for delivering the online lecture. The number of students who wants to join your lecture will join the by using that link shared by you or the invitation that you are given to the students. As soon as your students join your wants to join your lecture, you will find a new pop-up on this window coming. They want to join your session. You just have to click on admit button. By clicking on admit button, the user will get the access to your online lecture. So when you do that, you will find this number here is increasing. Right now it is 1. It means I am only the person available into this online lecture. If you allow other students to join your session, you will find this number is increasing. See, suppose there are 15 students who joined, you allowed that student to join your lecture, you will find the count is 16. Including you, it will be 16. You can check the attendance of all the online students by clicking on this, like this. So there will be a list of students here. There will be a list of students. After your name, there will be so many student names who join your online lecture. They can ask their doubts into the chat room by typing their message into this chat box, or they can unmute their mic and they can ask the question directly into the live session through microphone. Whenever your students join the session, ask them to mute their microphone and this video. This is the way we can mute the microphone. Just by clicking on this microphone icon, I can mute the microphone. If you want to talk, just unmute the microphone. There is another button called as camera, turn off camera. You ask the student to turn off camera as well as microphone when you are delivering a session, and you ask them to unmute the camera or microphone when they want to ask the question to you in the live lecture. There is another way they can ask the question is by using text. They can type text into the chat room here. Okay, here they can type their questions. Here you will get the attendance of all the students who are attending your lecture. Now, if you see this bottom part of your screen, there are certain icons. This is microphone icon. This is the joining or leaving the current session, exiting from the current session. When you want to stop your lecture, you just click this button. This is the camera icon, which allows you to mute or unmute the camera of the externals, other persons. Then this is the button which allows you to present your PPT on your screen. And you can share. As soon as you click on present now, you will find, suppose I select your entire screen, then I will get this window on my screen where you can share your content. Click your on share. So when you click on share button, as soon as you do that, the screen of your machine will be shared to all the participants. And click on share button. Okay, so I'll select and then share this screen. So this screen will be shared to my students.